Hey everyone, this is Corinne Lacroix, your favorite radio host, your only radio host and favorite girl, of course, broadcasting to you from the lovely island of Trinidad and Tobago in the Caribbean on Between the Lines. And you know, I start my show off with gratitude or thankfulness. I am so thankful to be here another day, another new set of blessings. Yes, there are fresh blessings every day. Never runs out, yes? So I am thankful. I'm thankful for all the lessons that I've learned so far in the day and still to learn, and to be able to spread love to all the people that come into my space, physically or otherwise. I am thankful. I have with me today Nancy White. She looks like an actress. Oh my goodness, you know, when I look at Nancy, she reminds me of, I don't know, like Elizabeth Taylor, you know, that sort of royal look. You just have that look.
Oh.
Elizabeth Taylor. I am serious. She's so beautiful. And we're talking about the benefits of journaling. Yes, I'm feeling her spirit coming through, even though, you know, she's at a distance from me. I can tell these things. So we're speaking of the benefits of journaling. And let me tell you a bit about Nancy and we'll get straight into it. So Nancy White dreams about living in a world where people will thrive and not just survive, both physically and financially, and I will add in spiritually. Mm-hmm. Nancy, a native of Charlotte, North Carolina, has a passion for teaching and coaching people to live naturally healthy lifestyles through proactive, preventative choices. Through her business, the Healthy Cells Chick, she looks like a chick, she has helped more than 700 people improve their health through the choices they make. Welcome, Nancy, to Between the Lines.
Oh, thank you, Corinne, so much for taking time to just get together and get to know each other better, but to share any kind of tips that we can to help others.
Yes, and I appreciate that. And anything along healthy lines and healthy living and having a balance, successful life, you know, joy and happiness. I'm all about that. So I want you to share with me, how did you get started on this journey? Were you always this healthy cell chick? Oh, what happened to you before that led you into this? Because you know, it always has to be something that kicks us in the butt, slaps us in the back of the head to get us started. Tell me what that could have been, or what was that to get you on this journey?
Well, Corinne, it goes back to when I was 9 years old and my father died of Hodgkin's, and leaving my mom with four children to raise by herself. And so then when my older brother, John, at 22, had discovered his own leukemia while he was studying to be a doctor, he lived 2 years longer. And so I have always been on a track for the 36 plus years in learning about preventative healthy lifestyles. And my beautiful, blessed mom was 96 when she moved home to be with the Lord. And she was a great influence, Corinne, on my life. We were using fun things like colloidal silver, and she was juicing long before juicing was popular. And personally, I still don't like juicing, but I love getting great nutrition in my body to make a difference. So that was the journey that started for my quest to learn about natural, healthy, preventative lifestyle, and the journaling part has just evolved over the last decade or so. I'm 67, so I'm still planning to go a long ways before I move to heaven, but that was the beginning.
Oh, nice. So, I mean, it's always the moms, eh? It's always the moms. I'm telling you that influences our lives. What is it about moms that does that? What is it? Are you a mom?
I am a mom. My youngest is 33 and I have a 36-year-old and then a stepson. So yes, I am a mom.
So what is it about moms that has that sort of healthy, caring, you know, outlook that they pass on? They're always passing on wisdom. What do you think that is? I mean, I'm a mom too. I may have my own answers to that.
I know, and I'm sure you do. And I think what it is that, Corinne, we really want what's best for our children, and then to be able to empower them and to learn some things that we might not have learned quite so young. Mm. And so if we can help them to speed up that learning curve sometimes. And, you know, I've learned also over the years as my children got older and adults that I can share information, be permission-based, and then be quiet.
That's right.
They're adults. I know.
Yeah, you have to know when to talk and when not to talk, when to leave them be, let them learn their lessons, you know, fall, get up, you know, dust off and, you know, learn and move along, yeah?
It is. But I think, like you said, it's a heart's desire for us to be able to help our children become their best versions of themselves and to be self-sufficient and make good choices. And when they don't make a good choice, that's where a lot of grace and space comes in.
Grace and space. I love that. Grace and space. I'm certainly going to use that. Grace and space. Now, listen, you are talking about the benefits of journaling. Now, I can tell you, I started back journaling recently. I'm not as consistent as I should be because I believe that journaling should be every day, consistent. You know, I'm not going to say a specific time, but what I recommend to people is that you walk with that little book, or now you have your phones, you can always journal in your phones. And once a thought or an idea or a trigger or something happens to you, you're able to document what you're feeling. Ask yourself questions. It's amazing that when you start writing, and I'm talking about this from experience, I don't know about yours or others that you may know, that in writing out your thoughts, your mind just flows and flows and flows. And it's like you start getting answers to your own challenges, errors, questions, whatever it is. Even if it's a trigger and you're writing about how you feel about this particular trigger. And a trigger could be a one word or a phrase that somebody used that bring up a traumatic experience or something that doesn't make you feel good. When you start writing how you feel or why you're feeling this way, you end up going way back. Memories start coming at you that you probably didn't even want to deal with, Nancy. I want you to share with me why you're so passionate about journaling as a way of healthy living.
Okay, and Corinne, it's something that I have not done all of my life, but I've been a researcher for years, and I used to be a researcher for the government before children. So when I started researching some of the benefits, the health benefits of journaling, I came up with some very interesting information. It was a gentleman, a professor that was from Texas that did a great study, and they said that people that journal actually can increase their immune system. They can increase or decrease symptoms, not cures, symptoms of people with asthma and rheumatoid arthritis. There's ways that when we are journaling and we're writing, that left side of the brain is our side that's just amazing for cognitive and all those things, but it creates the freedom for the right side of the brain to be able to be creative at the same time. So it physically does some amazing things for our brain. One of the other things I think is interesting is that it helps us to clarify our thoughts. It helps us to stop long enough to write down some things. Just like you said, that it helps to unscramble that big ball of rubber bands that we have going on all the time. And it helps us to sort out some things. It helps us to be able to identify areas that we may have triggers that are causing us to make some not so great choices sometimes. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, helping people to be more self-controlled and self-accountable, that's what I think one of the things that journaling does is it helps us to take a little bit more control back about the things that we are doing for our own health and the things that we are doing to be our best version of ourselves. So the other thing too, Corinne, it helps us to build empathy. It can help us to feel calmer. There's so many things that we get to know ourselves better but it reduces stress. And in our country, stress is associated with the 6 top killers. And so it's one of the things that helps us to manage stress, so stress doesn't manage us.
Yeah. And sleeping better. I think it helps you to sleep better because you're pouring yourself out into those pages that by the time you're ready to sleep, you're so much more calmer, which is really how you should be going to bed. You don't want to go to bed with anxiety because you wake up with anxiety. You want to go to bed calm and detoxed and, you know, in a more meditative state. Yeah.
You could be my commercial, because what I did was back in May, I launched my GRT journal, and it stands for Gratitude, Reflections, and Tips. And it is a wonderful, simple tool for people that have not journaled before, but even people that have journaled. And it's to use 10 minutes at the end of each day and to fill out information and reflect over the day. And there's some areas where they get to check off some of the things for their choices of drinking, eating, sleeping, exercising. So it's a great way for people at the end of the day to reset their heart and their mind to be grateful and to sleep with that sweet peace. And then wake up, you know, and get to start again. But I also journal in the morning too. And when this book came out and I hit Amazon bestseller from a friend that was helping to coach me, I love friends that help coach. The Lord gave me a thought. He said, well, next year, he said, you can change the title to this, to GRT-PM. And then the one for next year is going to be GRT-AM. Yeah. And so the whole vision for the cover and everything in it. So, but. Yeah. It's just one of those things.
And do you realize that people, I mean, not that they do text language, they write GRT for great. Short for great is amazing.
Yeah.
But gratitude and being thankful is always the best way. Throughout the day, Nancy, I'm always saying thank you.
Me too.
Thank you. I'm sitting in a class. Yesterday I went to a class, and while I'm there, I am just so grateful to be in the class because it has been a dream of mine for so many years. So many years, and it was my second session, and I'm watching my lecturer talking, and I'm hearing the words, I'm seeing him move, but I was in a different space. All I was saying was thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm seeing him move, and I'm hearing words. I can't say, well, I mean, I'm understanding what he's saying, but I was in a different space that meant so much more to me to just say thank you. Thank you.
And there's days, Corinne, that I don't ask the Lord for anything. It's going to be thank you day.
Yes.
I love it. And I'm a clapper. And so I love giving the Lord hand claps.
Me too. Me too. I do that. I clap and I look up and I'm like, yay, you're on to something. You know, it's amazing. And when things happen, like, you know you want to happen and you see it actualize, you're like, oh my God, you're awesome. You know, I cannot imagine, Nancy, people living a life that they're so busy, they cannot stop for a second to say thank you, to recognize that everything that they have is not of them. No. I cannot understand that life. My brain, my mind cannot be wrapped around that. I guess because I choose not to. And so, you know, I just can't think of that. It's just unimaginable to me. And you said reset. That is so important. We know how to reset the button on our phones, reset the button on our computers and our TV. But we don't realize, and those are inanimate objects, and we are living human beings, and we don't realize of all the things, the one thing that needs resetting is us every day.
Every day. Every day we ask for the renewing of our minds, and I even ask for the reprogramming sometimes, Corinne. The renewing of our minds.
And the reprogramming, because, you know, if you were to become an aware person, which takes time and is a work in progress, you would realize a lot of the things that you were taught from a child. You have to undo all of that. You have to reprogram, because it has made you into the person that you are. And you mentioned a phrase, a better version of yourself. And to get to that point, a better version of you, you cannot be holding on to the programming of what your parents and the society gave you as a child. You have to let it go.
And it's a choice every single day. It's a choice, because you and I both know that the enemy's there to steal, kill, and destroy. And we've got the bullseye on us. He's not going to mess with anybody in his own camp. Yeah. And so every day we get to put on that helmet, the breastplate, the whole armor. And every day we get to start afresh and anew. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're going to get to go through those tests and trials. But, you know, some days I pass better than others. But you know what? As long as I get to wake up, put my feet on the ground, it's a brand new beginning.
To open your eyes, to wake up and move around. I got up this morning and I was thanking my feet. I thanked my body. I said, feet, thank you for carrying me when I couldn't carry myself. When I'm so tired to walk, you know, you never give up on me. Even though you had to rest, take a few minutes, you got up and go again. You know, I thank my toes, my body. I start touching from the bottom up. You know, just thanking. I couldn't name all the different parts of my body, you know, internally and so on. But I just, you know, I mention all of them in a way. I say, thank you for serving me. You know, it's one I have. I cannot go into the cupboard and change it, Nancy.
I know. And we need to be grateful and thankful for the way God created us. And when women especially get so bent out of shape because they start comparing.
Yeah.
And when we grumble about the way we are, whether it's our looks or whatever it is, we're telling the Lord he didn't do a good job.
Oh, gosh.
I will never, ever, ever. I say, thank you, Lord. I thank you for making me, because I was made in your love and your heart and your
Image and likeness. Journaling, the benefits of journaling. And you had mentioned in when you wrote to me to be on my show about a hidden and not so hidden. And, you know, we just want people to try it. You know, we want people to try it. It's amazing. Just writing things down. And, you know, you would watch those movies long ago where they say their diary. That's really what it is. Their diary.
And it's a great tool for us to use for ourselves, Corinne. You know, it's not about anybody else. It's between, you know, what's going on with us and the Lord or just whatever it is. But it's taking that time to stop, enter again, reflect, write down these things. And I love it, because without a vision, the people perish. And part of my journal that I created, there's areas where people write down their goals. They write down their things, and then they can reverse engineer it and do the steps to it. So, you know, we don't have to have so much complication, but we do need to have, you know, things that are goals and visions and dreams, and to be able to know and reflect back. Because when we have a PUE day, you can pick up your journal and you can read something. It's amazing that the Lord did out of the clear blue, and you did not orchestrate it.
Yeah. Because we tend to forget. Even pictures, I would tell people to put in their diary. Take a picture of whatever it is, you know, like I'm talking about it now. I should take a picture of me in my class, that I achieved that, you know, though I wouldn't forget. But little things, just take a picture, because you may forget as you go down the road. And it will take something to knock you upside the head to remind you where you came from, to start appreciating. Wow, journaling is very good. I need to become more consistent with it, though. More consistent every night, or every day, you know. I have it right. I'm looking at it right in front of me. And let me see if I can grab it here, because the cover of I got it as a gift after speaking in Texas a few years ago. Was it 2017? And I got it as a gift, and I cherish it. It's a lovely hard cover, and it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight and clear. Proverbs 3:5. That's the cover. So I have this in front of me all day, every day. You know, it's on my bed. I sleep with it. I see it. I wake up with it in the morning. I go to bed. I mean, it's my partner, you know.
Well, I would love and be honored if I could send you a copy of the GRT journal, just so you could use it and see how you like it, like at the very end of the day.
Yeah.
Just sort of help you. I know you already have such an incredible, loving, grateful heart. But if it's something that you would like, then you can let me know and I would love to send you one.
Thank you so much. I want to hop across now to your website. Let me see if I can share that. Where do I have the page? I had it up a while ago. Nope, wrong page. Give me a second. Let me see if I can find the page. Oh, you know what happened? I couldn't find your page, Nancy. I was having a difficulty getting access to your website. Why is that?
I don't know. It's www.thehealthy sales, and it's CELLSCHICK.com.
Tell me again. THE
Healthy, HEALTHY. Sales, CELLS. Chick, CHICK. .com.
Or .com. Hold on one second. I think you sent me the link in the email.
I did.
But I need to check that. It came up now. I think probably there may be a misspelling in the email you sent me. One second. It came up now. I'll have to check back. So here we go.
Yay, there it is.
Yeah. Health and vitality every step of your journey. Isn't that awesome? I saw something today. I can't remember where I saw it, but I shared it with someone. With every breath I take, my body and mind heals, or something like that. With every breath I take, my mind and body heals. Yes. Yes, that's awesome. So here we go. So tell us a little bit about your website. Is there anything that you're giving away on your website, Nancy?
I am, and I have a healthy self-check wheel that people can download, and it evaluates the self-check in 10 different areas. And then there's also healthy suggestions that go along with that. Mm-hmm. And that's something I love giving people. And also, if they wanted to purchase the GRT journal, I tell them to go through here because they will have free shipping and they'll save $5. And not anything against Amazon, but I like saving people money. And so that's something. And then I've just come out with something else. I'm going to be adding in, I'm getting ready to do a health summit on stress. And I have created a great self-check for stress.
Nice.
To evaluate. So, yes, I would love
Okay, so here, this is a journal that they can pick up. And of course, they can also get your free health wheel checkup here. And where have you posted on your website yet, that summit?
I have not. I'm in the process of creating that and working with about 20 other health coaches.
Oh, nice. And persons can contact you here, which is your contact button form, your name, email, message. Yes. So even if persons want to find out about the summit, they can ask about it here. Would you mind telling us a bit about the summit? How long will it be for?
It's going to be starting in October, and we're going to have about a week long of just different people that are in the health arena coming and talking about the different ways that we can help manage stress in all types of ways, and just sharing those tips and that information. But I'll send you the information and the link. It is in the process of being created. We're going to pre-record the shows and so the events, and then we're going to be uploading them and being able to help people to be able to have access.
Oh, nice. Let's check out your services here. Oh, you have for millennials, moms, and baby boomers. I wonder if I'm a baby boomer.
I don't know what they're going to call the next generation after us.
I'm a baby, so I'm going to look at a baby boomer.
I know.
I'm always a baby. So this is what they get under the baby boomer. So it depends on how you consider yourself. If you're a millennial, a mom, or a baby. Well, I'm a baby, so I clicked on the baby boomer.
Good. And so, the main thing is just, you know, Corinne, is I love getting things offline as fast as possible because I really want to hear about the good things people are doing for their healthy lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And then I would love to offer them some suggestions and areas that they want to shift or tweak. It's not what I think they need, it's what they know. And I love helping cancer thrivers, because that's my big passion, is sending those people list of information to help them to have peace of mind. They get new bodies every 6 to 8 years, and there's ways that they can do their own self-checking to give them that assurance they're doing their best and God's going to do their rest. But you know, there's wonderful practical things that people can do to have that just sort of that assurance and that knowing that they are protecting their body the best they can.
We have 3 more months, so we are almost finished September. Imagine that. Mm-hmm. And we have October, November, December to finish 2019 and going running to 2020 with a bang. What would you say to persons closing off? They have 3 months, a quarter of a year, yeah? What would you say to persons to do between now and the end of the year to start building a sort of discipline, mm-hmm. especially for me? So I'm asking that question for me too. A discipline and consistency going into 2020. They have 3 months. What should we do?
And it takes about 20-30 days to start changing those habits. So I would say to use technology, because everybody usually has a smartphone with a calendar in it. Mm-hmm. And so scheduling that time with a pretty color that you like every single day to do some things that are good for you, whether it is exercising, whether it is taking time to just sort of self-evaluate, because I believe in healthy mind, body, and spirit, just like you're talking about. Mm-hmm. So you cannot separate them. But looking to stop long enough, and that's what I love to talk with people about, is to stop long enough to assess where you are today and where you want to be for the future. And it doesn't have to be overwhelming. So I think it's really important for people between now and the end of the year to look at it as just going and going with the flow. And when we go into 2020, it's not like a stop, start. You're continuing on, because maintaining good health is an effort and it is work and it's choices. And it's not just something, it's not a quick fix. But as we age, I got to work out with Arnold Schwarzenegger when I was 20, and that was 40-something years ago. But, you know, I do holy yoga now. I still work out and do things, but I've changed it from when I was 20 in the gym, you know, working out with all the weights and the machines and everything. So I think just having people to just stop, acknowledge the good things that they're doing, and then just sort of see the areas that they need to tweak and make shifts in, and schedule it into your calendar. And we have to schedule those times, just like you're talking about, for gratitude. Yeah. And women, we're so busy. I'll say, take a bubble bath, throw Epsom salts in, light a candle, relax. It's part of your healthy lifestyle.
That's right. That's right. It's amazing how you mentioned Arnold Schwarzenegger. Just yesterday, I watched a video on YouTube about him and his workout, and that man still looks good. He's still working out. He said not as how much he would have worked out when he was Mr. Olympia and Mr. Universe and all of that. I mean, gosh, but he still has a body. He's still eating healthy. Mm-hmm. You know, he has accomplished so much in his life that now he just goes to the gym and he's like inviting people, come, you want to work out with me? Come, let's have some fun, you know. He's all about having fun, you know. And I like how you said it. No pressure. You have 3 months. It takes an average of 21 to 30 days to develop the habit. And you have 3 months to do that, right? Yeah. You have 3 months to do that. So if you didn't get it right the first month, October, you try it again, November. By December, it must work. Something must stick, you know. And we just keep going like that, you know. We just keep going like that. Oh my goodness, this is amazing. Something happened with your video there. Nancy, I'm not seeing you. I'm not hearing you either. Nancy, where did you go?